So, it's 1 a.m. I'm down at Spreckles Park. Actually, I'm over at my church saying a prayer for a sick friend and saying one for me too, because I need one too. But there's this new phenomenon that's going on right now. It's called Pokemon Go or whatever. And you get groups of people like gathering, just like people, you hear? People are sitting over here in the car playing it. I came across 10-year-olds, with a woman, of course, sitting on the corner here. It's kind of scary because they're just sitting there on the corner playing this game, and the computer's got these games all over town. Like, there's another one. The computer tells you where the Pokemon is, and you go try to capture it. And it's been kind of interesting to watch, but I noticed a couple of dangerous things tonight. And that concerned me about the craze. It's about gathering of people in a certain spot that could be potentially hazardous to everybody's life. For example, my wife drove me down here earlier, and like on 3 or 4 occasions at least, kids in dark clothing just stepped off the sidewalk, totally oblivious to that we were even there, playing that game with their head down in the machine, in the phone. And my wife was very nervous because every corner you drive around, there'd be kids on it, and that's what it is. Part of the game is that you follow the Pokemon. So the kids are driving all over town now in groups. I saw a mother get out of a car with 5 kids, and I'm talking about 7, 8, 9, 10, like that. Kind of kids, all out in the middle of the night, all playing a game, all hooked on this. I know they go to school, they go to work, or whatever it is, but out here, there had to be 60, 70 of them, and there they are. They're still there. So the computer will say, okay, Pokemon is now at 10th and Orange. So they all just gallop right across the median, right across, no crosswalks, no, headlong, perch headlong, as the quote goes, on the edge of boredom. And they all just gallop to where the computer tells them it is, without even a thought of traffic or anything else. They're like a mob. I was down here and I just saw them all going, "Argh!" Like a horde, you know, somebody from Braveheart. They're all just galloping down the lawn. And they just crossed without even looking, as I say. So it really concerned me. And I'm here to keep my eye on it in one way and see, you know. My son plays it fervently, and so do his friends, and it's like, but the idea is to keep moving now, I see. So anyway, this is a report, and I'll keep you updated. They all assemble here for some reason. That's the main, right in front of the Day and Night Cafe. And even though the Day and Night Cafe is not open, they sit out here and play, sit in their cars. You'll see them sitting in the cars. Now, this is half the amount that was. No, I even recorded because it was jammed a while ago. And so you capture this Pokemon, and then it's you put it into a Pokemon station or whatever it is, and you get, there are 139 characters in there. The goal is to capture them. Now, it looks like half the people have gone home, but look, you see Straggler, there he is, right in the middle of nowhere, not on the sidewalk, not on the medium. Oh, now he's on the medium, he's just stepped up, no shoes on, hoodie on, head down. Look, this is what he does, right across the street, without regard. See, his head is down. There's some oncoming traffic this way. Look, he's right here, completely and utterly something about to happen. Negative, I'm afraid to say. Somebody walks into something, or some drunk Navy guy, not with this whole crew, doesn't know what it's all about, just keeps driving too fast, hits somebody. That's my concern, you see? People are preoccupied with this game because it's kind of spellbinding, but I think it has some potential drawbacks here. Something is not, I'm afraid what you're going to see is the police are going to come and regulate this, or ban it or something, or make some strict rule, because so far there have been no incidents, but there could be. See, people are now coming and going at hours that they would normally be in bed. Or, you know, There'd be a few drunks out cruising around, but essentially you've got the upper-fied kids here, all middle-class kids, mostly, actually, they're not even from Coronado. Most of them are from a South Bay, Filipino, Asian, or whatever. Mostly minorities playing it, not white people at all. And I don't know how many times I've redone that restaurant, but there you go, see little groups of people. Hi again, there you are. I talked to those kids, they were very nice. And I was trying to find out, well, did you make any money at this? Can you get a bet down? No, no, we just capture Pokemons. See, two over there on the median, cruising cars, they're all here looking for this. Whatever it is, the computer is telling them, come down here to 9th and 10th and Orange and watch out for Alan Graham. And everything else is closed down, but people are cruising and bruising. And by the way, they're all sober, they're not on drugs. The only drug they're on is this addicting machine called the internet. And they are running on, what's the word? I call it silent running, but there you are, see? Right on the corner of nowhere. And I don't know why they choose to, like, I would make it mandatory that everybody wear sparkling neon. There you go, like, look at this fella. Riding down the street on his bike with his, there's two other kids here. Where's the Pokemon?
Yes.
Where is it?
Oh, it's all the way at C.
C? I gotta go down to C. C? And they start talking to each other and telling each other what it is. And me. So, say hi to Elvis in the Mouton. There's the cow. Where's Elvis? There he is. There you are. This part of town is usually quiet, but look, it's 1:30 in the morning and people are sitting in their cars, and they're not doing bad. They're doing Pokemon Go or whatever. They don't even get out of the cars now. It's just like, here you go. Well, there you have it. Al Graham for Worldwide Crime Watch, Coronado Clarion, and just plain old me checking out what the heck is going on right here in River City. Yeah, anywhere and everywhere. Little groups of people all playing Pokemon Go. Do 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 do. Now, there are going to be some rules and regulations. I guarantee you, soon the police will show up and say, wait a moment, you can't just run in the street dressed in black. What if you get killed? So far, as I say, nothing's happening. I think I'm ahead of the curve here, trying to do a, you know, predict what's going to happen if something, you know, well, let's just say something that could happen. And there you have it. So far, sanity is ruled. You can find them anywhere, little corner. Oh, there you go. All in black. Now, why is that? Why is everybody dressed in black? Is that some kind of like group thingy or who knows? Maybe they're just like, that's the style du jour. Yeah? There's somebody trying to land, you see? Yeah, that's the part that concerns me. People just wondering, like, you know, zombies. Not much down that way. And it looks like it's kind of abated. There was a 60, 70 strong, and in the very least, maybe even more. And they were all just hoarding, like, argh! just galloping down the median. It's over there, the Pokemon's over there. And there you have it. But they weren't just a mindless crowd, they were more like techie mindless. See, you know what I mean? It's like, the interesting thing is the music that they're listening to. Rap, of course. But that's another aspect of Pokemon. What kind of music does this average person listen to? You know there's going to be a Pokemon song put out very soon by me, more than likely. The Pokemon craze, retro, retro Pokey, we'll call it. Down on the median corner, what a look at this. All kind of people now showing up, a mix of people. I thought it was all over, now they start showing up again. Like, look at that. Oh, walking right toward the mail truck, and he stops. And he wasn't looking. My God, this is really worrying an old man here. More than likely, there's no reason to worry, but because nothing's happened so far. Knock on wood. People on motorcycles showing up. Oh, people, I don't know if they're coming or going. If they're bringing chairs or taking them. So I'm going to get down in the weeds off the bike and into the crowd. There's an after 8 p.m. crowd. Apparently that's when the activity starts. But I see them in the daytime too. I know it's being played all over the world, but here in Coronado, it's at 9th and Orange, right in front of the Night and Day Cafe, across from the movie theater, right by Rite Aid. But that's not where they all are. They're all over town, and there's a map that tells you where everybody is, and people come and go all the time, willy-nilly. Apparently they computer tells them Pokemon is over here, so they all rush over here. A little while earlier, there had to be 60, 70 people, at least. And then, out of nowhere, they just suddenly all stood up and all just marched down that way real quick, because the Pokemon was landing on the next block. And then I came back 15 minutes later, and the crowd had thinned out, but most of the people are not from Coronado, and I wonder why that is. He just cruised up on his motorcycle over there, and he stopped and playing Pokemon on his bike. So it's kind of like a movable feast, movable crowd. They'll just get up and move. And it kind of reminded me of the 60s happenings in the middle of the night when I was a kid in England. All these people. And then, of course, they had the flash mob. That was a mindless, silly, comical thing. But this is serious. This is commerce here. These people are purchasing an app, and they're playing the game. And it's just a matter of time before some ancillary product comes out right alongside it, you know, either complementing this or riding the coattails of whatever this is into the marketplace. And I can see it that the average person here has got a little income. So that's also disposable income we're talking about here. even though it's just an app, they're here putting the hours in, and I wonder how to apply that to a higher marketing strategy. And there you have it. And now, once again, it's about 2 a.m. and people are starting to show up again. I don't know why that is. I guess people are out driving around all night. Look, everywhere you go, hanging out of cars, hanging on corners. That was empty 2 minutes ago. Now it's full up again. This was had a few people a few minutes ago. Now about 10 more have gathered. So that's the interesting part to me, to see what is this trend and how long will it last. And if people are out here chasing the Pokemon, what else will they come out for? And it's how it's marketed, isn't it? And by the way, I found all my son's old Pokemon cards. So there's another. We haven't seen the ancillary. How you doing today? Got somebody filming me. That's interesting. Usually I film them. Al Graham for the Coronado Clarion. Of course, there's etiquette. I forgot to tell you that. You don't want to walk up to a Pokemon and he's in the middle of trying to capture the Pokemon. So you've got to be sure that if you want to even talk to someone, they're not in the middle of a game, which is like all-consuming. I mean, this little Pokemon is kind of like, you know, like in hypnotic. It is like, and then we meet rude people like him, and he's proud of it too. But that's America, isn't it? Bloody good. You can say anything you want, anytime you want, because we have freedom of speech here. As I say, most people are very, very polite and kind of nice people. But you'll get, once in a while, you'll get a real dick will come out and just to be a dick, he'll be a dick, like him over there, pencil neck. There you go. Nice dicking.
More stuff to say to me?
Come here, young man, I'll talk to you. That's what I'm talking about. Now. See, this is where it could get sticky. These people looking, they stop, the lead comes up behind them, and it's like, all you need is one drunk sailor to bash into somebody. Even though none of these people appear to be intoxicated, it's just this slowing and impeding the flow of traffic that concerns me. Of course, I'm an old codger now. A little concerned I'm going to get hit in the crosswalk and break my pelvis. So the game goes on day and night, of course, but there seems to be like a night crew that comes out about 8 p.m. and they all gather by. It's growing every day, by the way. It was just, it used to be like 10 or 12 people. And then all of a sudden, I saw tonight a surge. Another thing I noticed, a product that they use are those vaporizers. You see these plumes of smoke go up from their mouth. And I went, what? It's those vaporizer cigarettes. That's one product I see them consuming, besides the app. And like if you're near a restaurant and it's open, food is purchased. So commerce is behind this. And not really, not deliberately, but by osmosis. And so trying to gauge this market ahead of time, ahead of the curve, trying to find out what would it consume if we have it, some kind of byproduct that says Coronado Pokemon Searches or Coronado Adventurers.
Oh my God, yes!
There you go. That was that same fool over there who was just rude and proud of it, doing a kind of a, like a psychotic scream just now because he missed the Pokemon. And that's the other thing. Psychologically speaking here, this is kind of, what's the word of this? They suspend belief here for a minute and you enter into a fantasy world of capturing this little icon or whatever it is, and your whole emotions change. You start screaming like a Tourette syndrome patient, you know, involuntary vulgarities and stuff like this. And I hear it all the time and it's kind of like, that's interesting to me. As a behaviorist, I also wonder, do these people go to school, go to work? How do they do this? Or do they just have a, you know, go in at noon kind of thing? They're night people, more than likely, because you couldn't be doing this all night and then go do a regular job in the daytime. You'd be falling asleep. So I'm assuming that these people are night people. But I noticed that rude guy there, he's always alone. People talked to him for a little bit, but he said, oh, the others will kill him. That's probably because he's a dick. But I don't mean that in a good way, if you know what I mean. Anyway, this is my report, and I'm sticking to it. Well, it seems to be abating now. People seem to be peeling off, and little pox is a bit everywhere. Yeah, I think people are shutting it down for this evening. So, yeah, they're slowly ambling back this way now, whereas there were five people. Now look, suddenly, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, another dozen just roaming. So they didn't go away, they just moved away. Now they're moving back. It's kind of like the zombie apocalypse, if you know what I mean. They're all kind of, look, see, walking like automatons, looking with their heads down at their phones. See? They're way down, all the way down the street, all over. So they didn't go anywhere, they just dispersed into little groups, and now they're assembling again. I guess that's where the Pokemon machine goes. I'm going home. I'm very tired.